Beginner's Course on Autodesk Fusion 360. My name is Avye Jamadagni, and today we will be looking at how to use a window selection option, and basically an option or a tool that will help us select many objects or any many sketches or anything at the same time. The basics of it is you click on anywhere, and you just drag to activate the window selection. And let's just draw a box over this just to see how it's going to look like. And there you go. So that's basically what it does. It just selects everything that's in that box. So first what we're going to do is we're going to start by extruding each of these squares that we made a few lessons ago. But it's going to be really difficult or really time consuming to extrude and select every one of these squares. Instead, we can use this window selection option to select all of them at the same time. So let's go ahead and do that. First, we'll go to a front view. And let's hide. Now we can still see the sketch that we created, that very first sketch. So let's go to our browser in the dropdown for sketches and hide sketch one. Let's close that. And now we have this. Zoom in a little. And let's go to the select button over here, select dropdown, and let's go to selection filters. Now, mine is currently selected at body faces, and that's what you want. Usually, this is your default, it's select all, so you're basically going to select every single thing. We don't want that now, so all you need to do is uncheck the select all box, and click on body faces. That's it. Now, click anywhere in the white space to deselect it. And what we're going to do is, we're going to go E, hit E for extrude. And see this tiny little space over here between this outer edge and these squares? We're going to click on that. And we're just going to draw a box over all of these squares. And what's going to happen is, it's going to select 51. But if you remember, we did 5 squares by 10, which is just 50. And we have one more profile that's selected, which we don't want. So that one profile is basically this outside, the main face of this face, the front face. So let's just click on that to unselect it. And now we have these 50 selected. Now, what we want is if you orbit around, you'll see that we only selected these faces and not even the lines around them. We want to cut into this. So to do that, let's just, in this tiny little box over here, let's just type in -1. And as you can see, it automatically updates to the cut operation because you're cutting inside. So let's go ahead and press OK. Because that's exactly what we want. And we have this. So we have a perfect pattern, exactly what we want over there. Now, let's go down here and let's do the exact same thing. So let's go to E for extrude. Now, this one, basically, we don't have many, so we can just select it as it is. Or you could use the window box, but that's just overcomplicating it. Anyway, so we have that. Now, what we want is we want this thing to stick out a little because it's a base, and it's probably going to be rubber in future. So we don't want to create a hole exactly like what we did for this. We just want to extrude this, say, a millimeter out. And that's it. It automatically updates to join. So let's go ahead and press OK. And that's it. And that's basically the window box select feature. It's really useful in these situations when you want to select many at a time. But sometimes it's irritating because when you select that, it automatically selects other things which you don't want to select. So make sure you always toggle with this selection filter over here. But for now, it's on body faces. Let's go ahead and check this select all button again, and let's just click on the white space. Now let's go ahead and save this. User saved, and that'll update to V6. So that was it for this lesson. Thank you so much for watching. The next lesson will focus on fillets, so we'll smoothen this entire thing out. And after that, we may look at appearances depending on how much time we have, and we'll also look at drawings, and our very last lesson will probably be on rendering. Anyway, thank you so much for your time and have a lovely day.